Swamiji, can you please talk about switching from an inauthentic guru to a scripturally authentic guru?
Guru means a pure guru. Gold means pure gold. If it is mixed with some other metal, it's not pure gold. Guru means pure devotee. A pure devotee is the only person who is authorized to accept disciples and function as a guru. Nobody else. Only pure devotees. A pure devotee is he who does not have any vices from the day one on this planet. That is pure devotee. If Guru himself cannot go back to Godhead, then he cannot take anybody else back to Godhead. My Guru gave an example. A dog may swim the water, but he cannot go across the ocean. Or a non-swimmer cannot hold the tail of a dog and go across the water. Not possible. That is logic, the scripture of logics. Nyaya Shastra says that Prabhupada repeated that. Bad guru, good guru. There is no word bad guru. There is no word good guru. Guru means guru, and guru is good always. Always good. If guru does accept any material things, or material pleasure rewarding object for some pleasure, that is considered to be a child who is a deep sleep and mother gives him a cup of sweet milk to drink. Wakes the child, gives him sweet milk, and child drinks and sleeps. And ask in the morning, child will not remember that he or she drank sweet milk at night. Similar position is of a pure guru. Guru is always pure, cannot be affected by material conditioning or material sense gratification. That is pure guru. If by chance, if guru is seen externally but don't know what is internal consciousness of that guru, and you got allured by seeing his buildings or by seeing his beautiful beauty of face or skin, beautiful skin, or he's flying around, he got many disciples, he got gold necklace around, or he talks so nicely, gives eloquent lectures, and you get initiated and you find out this man himself cannot go back to Godhead. Needless to say, take you back to Godhead. You found out real guru, a guru who is authorized by ancient scriptures to initiate, accept disciples. Guru has a guarantee himself going back to Godhead. He knows how to swim the ocean of material existence and can take you back to Godhead, take you other side of the ocean, material existence. Then you must immediately relinquish that guru and take to that person, that pure guru. Just like you got an 8-carat gold ring and you found out it's 8-carat gold ring and there is 24-carat gold ring also available. So what do? You immediately switch. Remove the 8-carat gold ring and take the real gold. If you have a brass ring and you found out there is a gold ring and you were cheated that, this is a gold ring but you got a brass ring and you found out it is a brass, it's not gold. You paid for gold, means you surrendered. You must immediately replace. That is smart job. Sadguru lavhiya punha Sri Krishna naam gai. Sadguru lavhiya must accept. Punha means again. Sadguru means pure guru. Lavhiya means accept. Punha means again. To chant your holy name purely, then you must immediately accept another guru who is pure. That is the procedure. Guru cannot be, it's not possible to have impure guru or guru who is not pure enough. Has to be a pure devotee sent by Krishna to this world to liberate you. Thank you very much.
Thank you, Swamiji.